Hi kids, we're back. Do you know, it's not just me. We've got Mike and Jessica. Hi. Now we're back for the next few Sunday mornings and we're here at 12:15. So make sure you join us because we've got lots of things planned and lots of fun for you. Now, children, we have a competition between Jessica and Mike. I'm going to set 1 minute on my phone and Jessica has to tell me when 1 minute is up. And then Mike is going to do exactly the same thing and we're going to see who's best. Now, if you want to get ready, perhaps you can join in when Mike does it and you can see if you're better than both of them. Okay, Jessica, are you ready?
Yes.
Okay, don't remember, it's 1 minute, 60 seconds.
Okay.
Yeah? Okay. Yes. Go. Jessica's score. Quite a good score that, Jessica.
Oh, okay, let me see it. Oh, that's nice. Okay.
Yes.
Let's see if Mike can beat me.
Okay, are you ready, children? We're going to give Mike a go now. Are you ready, Mike?
I am ready.
Okay, go. Come on, Jessica, distract him.
Yeah. So I will start counting in Portuguese. Let's see if he gets distracted with that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. Now in English. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. Now 40, 41, 42, 43. Just random numbers. Okay, are you okay? Are you concentrated?
No.
And this is Mike's score. I think he did well there with that huge distraction.
Oh no! Oh, wow, that's impressive.
It is. Now, I don't know how you did, children, but sometimes 1 minute is a long time to wait. And so sometimes you need patience to wait that minute. So I think overall they both did very well.
Thank you. Well done.
By my friend King Dave, wouldn't let the giant stand in his way. He said, hand me my sling, cause he's not that tall. My God is bigger and I watch him fall. My God's the king of the giants. My God's the king of the lions. My God's the king of the creatures of the deep. My God's the king of me. Have you heard the one about this guy called Dan? Yes, he was a mighty holy praying man. The I said, throw him to the den of the scary beasts. But God saved a hero from the lion's teeth. Yeah! My God's the king of the giants. My God's the king of the lions. My God's the king of the creatures of the deep. My God's the king of me. History, you will do the same for me, like Jonah and the whale at sea. When I'm lost and afraid, all alone in the dark, you're with me. Oh, you're with me. My God's the king of the giants. My God's the king of the lions. My God's the king of the creatures of the deep. My God's the king of me. My God's the king of the giants. My God's the king of the lions. My God's the king of the creatures of the deep. My God's the king of me. My God's the king of me.
So now we each have a label on our head, and we're going to try and guess what it says on our head by asking a few questions. Ooh. So, first of all, Fran.
Okay, all right. Am I an animal?
No.
No.
No. Am I a person?
Yes.
Am I a lady?
Yes. Yes.
Ooh, right, okay. Am I old?
Yes.
Well, at one point, yes. Not when they were born, no.
Okay. Do I have children or a child?
Yes.
Okay. Am I married?
Yes.
Am I a character from the Bible?
Yes.
I think I'm going to have a guess.
Okay.
I think I might be Sarah.
Yes, well done.
Sarah, you know, I know the story of Sarah. You know, she was the one that was married to Abraham, wasn't she? And they had to be very patient because Sarah, I think she was about 90 when she had her baby. And God had made them a promise that they were going to be like father, that Abraham was going to be father over many nations before they even had children of their own. So oh, wow. When this baby came along, they had been very, very patient. So that was a good example of patience.
Yeah, that's nice. That's a good story.
Mm.
Now, maybe Mike's turn.
Okay. Am I a vegetable?
No.
Am I an animal?
No.
Am I a person?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Have I got a beard?
Yes.
Okay. Okay. Am I a Bible character?
Yes.
Am I in the New Testament?
No.
No.
Okay. Am I in Genesis?
Yes.
Okay. Am I Abraham?
No.
Am I Noah?
Yes.
Okay. So Noah, wow, he needed a lot of patience because he was locked up in the ark, wasn't he? And the world was flooded, and he had to wait for the waters to go down before he could get out of the ark, before he could get away from all those smelly animals. So he needed a lot of patience.
Yeah, that's true. It's true. But it's a nice story.
Yeah.
Okay, my turn then?
Yeah,
yours.
Okay, let me start. Let me think. Am I an animal?
No.
No.
Am I a very beautiful lady?
No.
No.
Yeah. Am I famous?
Yes.
Okay. Am I from the Bible?
Yes.
Okay, so am I very rich?
Maybe.
Like a king or governor?
Yes.
Okay. Am I Joseph?
Yes.
Oh, nice. Yeah. Oh, yeah, Joseph needed a lot of patience as well because God had a plan for his life, but it wasn't always easy. He suffered a lot. Mm. But after a while, he became a governor because God has big plans. But yeah, Joseph had patience and he's waited for God's plans to unfold.
Great.
So there's one common theme through all these characters. They all had patience. They were all waiting on God to fulfill a plan in their lives. And they kept trusting God while they were waiting. They exercised a lot of patience.
True.
And patience is all about keeping calm, waiting, and not getting annoyed, really. So Mike and Jessica are going to give you some examples of being patient.
Well, one example is playing a game like chess. And especially if you're like playing against somebody like Jessica, who takes a long time to make a move, that can be very frustrating. So I need a lot of patience.
Another example of situation when you need to be patient is when you are waiting for a bus. So sometimes it will be late, so you need to wait.
And yesterday was bonfire night, and I remember when I was young, needing a lot of patience because my dad always used to come home late, and I remember waiting at the bus stop for him to come home so we could let our fireworks off, and that needed a lot of patience.
And Mike, how about when you're hungry?
Oh yes, especially when you're hungry and you want something to eat and you have to wait for a meal, whether your mum's making it or whether you're in a restaurant. You have to wait, and if you're hungry, that needs a lot of patience.
That's great, yeah. So patience, you learn that you need to be calm and wait. So children, I hope you've learnt a little bit from this, and next time if you feel that you're getting a little bit of impatient, then maybe you can remember the things that we've said about here today.
There's a proverb in the book of Proverbs in the Bible. In chapter 15, verse 18, it says, "Hot tempers causes arguments, but patience brings peace."
Let's pray together. God, thank you for what we've been looking at today. Thank you that you are perfectly patient with us. I pray that you would forgive us for the times when we aren't as patient as we should be with others, and that you would help us to be more patient when we find it hard. Amen.
So that's all we got for you today, children. So from me, it's goodbye.
And it's goodbye from me.
And it's goodbye from me as well.
So bye!